I'm Siddhi Karambelkar and I'm here to bring to you a very important topic for today, non-verbal kind of communication, your body language. Now, body language is way more important than the actual words that you say. Why is that? Because that tells you about the person you are and the person you want to be. So, there are many factors that influence the kind of body language that you have and they should. Number one, your thought process. Now, what you think about yourself, what you think others think about you will definitely display in the way you carry yourself. Point number two, the environment. Now, the people you are with. Now, definitely when you're with your boss or your teacher, you're going to have a different kind of a body language as compared to when you're at home relaxing with your mother, your parents, your loved ones, your siblings. And it should be different. Point number three, the knowledge that you have. So if you have the right knowledge of your field, you definitely have nothing to fear and you're going to walk and take yourself very, very confidently, and that will display in your body language. And point number four is your attire. Now, if your attire is too tight or too loose or uncomfortable in what you're wearing, it's definitely going to show in your body language. If you think you're too fat in the attire you're wearing, you're too thin, you're trying to conceal those areas, and it's going to be a disaster. So these are certain factors that influence your body language. So at least we can take care of those. Now there are a lot of areas when we talk about body language. Let's start with our first part, which is your feet. Now what are you supposed to do with your feet? Make sure you stand with shoulder distance apart. The reason why you do it is to get correct balance when you stand and correct energy throughout your body with the blood circulation. Make sure that your feet and your toes are pointing outward and not inward, because if it's inward, it shows underconfidence. It shows that you are not sure of what you are. If you stand too close, you might fall as you will not have enough balance, and it also displays a very uncomfortable kind of a body posture. If at all you stand on one and a half leg, it doesn't look too good. It shows that you're lazy, tired, and unwilling to be where you are. So make sure you concentrate on these few things. Make sure that you have your feet shoulder distance apart, the right kind of behavior. Also, if it's too far away, it's going to give a whole different look altogether, and it's going to be very, very ungraceful. Then when we come to your hands, what are you supposed to do with your hands if you're not too sure? When you're talking to people, do just be natural. Be natural when you talk. Don't concentrate too much on whether I'm supposed to keep it like this or like that. Just go with the flow. When you're talking, let your hands talk too. Not too much, or else they're going to concentrate on what your hands are saying rather than your words, but little to emphasize your points. Make sure that you do not stand in the Vivekananda pose, because that's going to show that you have a line, you don't want anybody to enter your territory. It gives a little bit of arrogance. If your hands are in your pockets, again, that shows a very stuffy attitude. If you have your hands over the other and on your forehead, again, it shows a little bit of underconfidence, and we don't want to put that across for sure. So make sure that your hands go with the flow, don't concentrate too much. You can have a regular decent posture like this, or lay them across your arms, or even use them as your gestures. So that goes with your hands. Let's come to our back. Now back postures again are very, very important. It can make or break your entire personality. So now when you have two kind of body postures, back in, chest in and back out, or back in and chest out. Now it's for you to decide how it looks when you have your back out and chest in. It definitely gives a very, very wrong approach. It clearly shows that you are not comfortable with the body type you have, with the person you are, and what you want to see. Nobody is going to take you seriously if you have that kind of a body posture. Take up your space. Throw your arms around. Broaden up your shoulders. You're here for a reason. Make sure you're confident. And that not only talks about who you are and how confident you are and the pleasant personality that you may display, but it also helps you in securing a lot of ailments that you may have with your body posture, back posture. So your lumbar bone or your tailbone and your spine needs to be straight. for a lot of reasons. You will gain a lot of prosperity if you concentrate on your back posture. Moving on to your head posture. You hold it too high in the air, nose up in the air. It's going to show that you are very, very arrogant. Who wants to be around people like that? You may not be arrogant, but it definitely displays that kind of an attitude. Nobody wants to have people around them who have a lot of air about themselves. Would you like it? Think about it. If you hold your head too low, again, it's going to show that you are submissive. It's going to show that you are not sure about what kind of a person you are. We do not want to display that kind of an impression, especially in the world that we are today. So make sure you have your head parallel to the ground. You have your head just enough that you can show that you respect people around you and yourself, more importantly. So hold your head high enough. Moving on to your eye contact. Now, the world knows that eye contact is the most important. Eyes are the windows of your soul. You will be able to make a point. The power that your eyesight and your vision has, no other body language has that kind of a power. So your eye contact is very, very important. What you say and how you say, how you react to when people are talking to you, again, will help you make a lot of friends and will make you a very, very social person with the right kind of eye contact. Now, number one, if you have your eye contact where you're just staring into a person, it's going to be very creepy. It's going to make them very, very uncomfortable. So make sure that you do not give that kind of an eye contact. Number two, if you are looking around when somebody's talking to you, maybe just giving them a little bit of eye contact and again looking around, they're going to feel that you're not interested in them. And you're showing that kind of body language where you're not interested in what they're talking to you, and it will go vice versa. They will not be interested to talk to you as well. Number three, if you keep stealing your eye contact with the person, you're not able to maintain an eye contact for a few minutes even. That again is going to show that either you're hiding something, you're underconfident, or you're a liar. Now that is going to help you too to gauge people around you as well. It directly represents your character. So make sure that your eye contact is right enough where you have a pleasant smile on your face. You're nodding in approval to where the person is talking to you. Just enough eye contact where you are intently listening to the person. A slight little quinch will help you show that you are a very, very intentive listener. After that, we will come to our smiles. Smiles, as we all say, smiles take you miles. Now that is again a very, very important part. Now if you keep smiling continuously without any reason, you will either show nervousness or you will show that you're a fake person or you're faking your smile. So don't smile too much. The right kind of smile, and I would say you cannot really concentrate on how much teeth you should show, how much smile you should have. We all know the difference between a laugh and a smile. Just go with your heart. Now, when you say that you have a beautiful smile, trust me, that smile syncs with what you have within your eyes, and all of that goes in sync, and that tells you that it's a beautiful smile. Whether you're showing 32 teeth or just 4 teeth, it doesn't matter. Just make sure it's from your heart. And trust me, that will help you touch all those hearts there. So these are a few things I would like to say. And the most and the last important thing of this topic is you're fidgeting when you're talking or interacting with people. Fidgety nature always shows restlessness, always shows that you're uncomfortable and want to get out of that place right away, and nobody's going to stand you around. So when you're fidgeting, you're displaying a very, very bad kind of impression. What can you fidget with? Either your fingers, a pen, your tapping of your feet, all of this shows a lot of restlessness. So we all know all these points, but we end up not concentrating on them. So after this video, I want you to have a look at what you are. When you talk in front of the mirror and see how you are talking, and that will help you in progressing in your corporate life and your personal life with your relationships. So please concentrate on your body language. It will take you miles. Stay glamorous, feel beautiful, be you. To know more, please do subscribe, share and like this channel. Bye bye, and thank you so much for watching.